This is amazing. It's absolutely brilliant.
I thought you'd just tell us to leave it in the boot and go home. I
get on the edge of that, yeah. No, never, never. Tell me all about it.
Well, it was on top of the Gosport Methodist Church spire for approximately 98 years.
Wow. Has it come down recently, or...?
No, it came down in 2002. We were having problems with pigeons.
Right.
And so we got a steeplejack in to stop the pigeons from roosting.
OK.
We said to him, while you're up there, can you have a look at the weather vane? So he put his ladders up, went up, and he came back down, and he says, I think you need to have it down. So we said, when? He said, yesterday. He said, because if you don't, it's in fear of falling off.
Causing some damage.
Causing a lot of damage.
It is very rusty. It needs an awful lot of work.
Yeah.
So it's going to be a very big job.
It's one of the letters missing, as you can see.
Yes.
So that'll be a challenge.
I think that's the least of the worries.
And everything inside there is seized up, so it won't swing with the wind.
This green part should be free to rotate.
Should be free to spin round. It never moved all the time that I was there, and I joined the church in 1975.
Wow.
I mean, I think I'd be weathered like that if I'd have been on top of a 90-foot spire for 100 years. Yeah. At least we've got all the bits.
Most of the bits.
Well, yes. Yeah.
So, I'm not making any promises, but if we can save it or at least get it into a bit better shape,
yeah.
What do you plan to do with it afterwards?
Well, what we would like to do is put it into the church garden.
Brilliant.
You know, at least it'll be on show then.
It's part of the heritage of the church. I think that's why it's important that we try and get it restored and people can actually see it again.
It's off to the repair shop Forge, a workshop specialising in the craft of bending and shaping metal. The blacksmith in charge is Nick Wedlock.
How we doing, Nick?
Hi, Jay.
You all right?
Yeah, not so bad.
This is what I was telling you about. Is it all right to put it on the bench?
Yeah, please do. Yeah.
All right.
So, look, I've made this as a kind of template. So, hopefully that makes sense as to what that...
It does.
Yeah?
It does. I can use that as a pattern.
Right.
Always like a bit of free labour, so...
I'm glad somebody noticed.
Doing a good job, Jay. Yeah.
The basic principles of the blacksmith's trade have remained virtually unchanged for over 3,000 years. The steel is heated to over 1,000 degrees Celsius, then shaped against the anvil by exact strikes of the hammer.
Let's have a look at that, compare it. Can we put that down on there? That is pretty much there, isn't it, don't you think?
Yeah.
Yeah, that'll be the first one done then. If they all come out as good as that, I'll be really pleased.
I'll be over the moon, yeah.
So how many we need of these?
Oh, we need like 10, 15.
15
maybe
of these?
Maybe more, yeah.
Oh, so we've got loads more to make.
Loads more.
Come on in, man.
Yeah.
I'm pumping away here.
I've got a piece here ready. Yep.
Good.
With the steel sections now intact, Dom can begin cleaning up the copper elements of the vane, hidden under 100 years of tarnish.
They've got this beautiful patina of all this verdigris on it, which is like an oxidisation, which is just a natural thing that occurs with copper when it's exposed to the element.
But having the copper letters gleaming and shipshape means a certain lack of direction is all the more obvious. Dom needs to recreate an E that will look A-OK alongside the other three markers.
Luckily, my degree is in graphic design, so I've actually spent a good few years working with typefaces and typography. So taking as much information as I can from the existing letters to recreate a matching E. That's fantastic. I think that sits really nicely alongside the original letters. I've now just got to give that a quick polish so the sheen level matches what I've done to the originals, file around the edges. But other than that, I think it's going to look great. It's almost time to fit it.
But having all four directions is pointless without a pointer. With the copper arrow also now gleaming, it can be soldered back onto the central shaft. But with his area of expertise lying more in the welding of steel and iron, Dom has called upon Steve.
Hey, Steve.
Who's more used to the delicate soldering of precious metals.
All right, let's get it all into position. This is a sort of fairly critical point.
If the pieces are not perfectly aligned, the newly soldered joins will break when the wedges and clamps are removed.
You're a bit low.
This is a bit of a fiddly job. I'm glad you're here to help.
Oh.
Steve. There we go.
Oh, that's...
Does that mean spot on?
No, that means almost.
Okay. Happy if you are.
Yeah.
So, let's give it a whirl. Not the easiest of soldering jobs.
No. I'm glad I didn't attempt it on my own. Thank you. That's great.
All right, leave it with you.
Thanks so much, Steve.
Dom's poured hours of hard work into the renovation. A huge item and one of the most damaged pieces he's ever faced. He's painted the nearly intact structure to replicate the original shade. And he's now gilding accents with gold leaf.
So I'm aware that weather vane's going back outside once it gets back to the church. For that reason, I've decided to use 23 carat gold, which it won't tarnish, basically. Anything less, 18 carats or any other silvers and coppers, would all tarnish with the weather. Working on projects like this, I've been so long thinking and planning and researching, I really do become quite attached to them, and I think it's really worth just going this extra mile, just putting the gold leaf on. It's really gonna do it justice.
Dom set a course to the coastal town of Gosport in Hampshire to deliver the weather vane back to the community.
It's been a very long road working on this weather vane. It's been a lot of hours and hours of quite difficult work. It was a lot worse than I originally thought it was going to be. So I'm feeling really anxious, excited, but really anxious to see Brian's face when he sees the weather vane. It looks so different to when he brought it down to us. I don't know how he's going to react to it. What are you hoping to see?
Even if you've only put another letter on and given it a coat of paint, you know, so it looks respectable, yeah. You know, that's all we would ask for.
Oh, I want to show it to you outside. I can't wait for you to see it outside. Yeah. I know there's a lot of people outside waiting to see it.
Can we get it melted?
You're itching to show them all.
I'm itching to get it out on the plinth.
I bet.
Yeah, let's get it outside and get it mounted. I've been on about it for weeks and weeks and weeks, and I think people were getting a bit fed up. Yeah, when's it coming? So now it's here, I think, now that they'll be only too pleased to come out. Very, very excited. All right, Joan. Are you all excited to see it? Because I am.
Yes.
Oh, right, let's go. Oh, my goodness me.
Wow.
Oh, goodness. Oh, look at that. It's moving. That was sea solid when we... And, oh, now we know which way the wind's blowing.
Absolutely fantastic. Don's done a marvellous job with it. I really can't believe how it's turned out. It really is wonderful.
That, to us now, will be cherished for years and years and years to come. I don't know how you've done it. I honestly don't. And look at the letters. We've even got an E.
It's a treat for me to see it again after all these years. It goes back a long way.
I am absolutely gobsmacked, you know. He's done a brilliant, brilliant job on it, and he deserves all the praise that he can get for doing it.